of Charlie Nicholas is carried off. And already Ian Allinson, the substitute for Arsenal, is on. Not the time to be making mistakes. Davis. Allinson onside. Now here's a chance for Arsenal. Gough trying to close him down. He's done it! It's 1-1!
Thank you.
Arsenal players lining up to get that one away. I think it was Kenny Sansom who finally got the touch through. Now Alisson running it to where it's safe as far as he's concerned. And here, Paul Allen having a little bit of a bust up. A free kick to Tottenham. Or rather a goal kick. Amazing record of Arsenal. They are through to Wembley. One of the great Littlewoods Cup comebacks. Those two late, late goals. One by Ian Alisson, and then the winner from David Rowcastle. Take Arsenal through to Wembley. So, a cup tie that's been full of astonishing twists, save the most dramatic and the most savage one, right to the very end. There's the hero of the hour, David Rowcastle. And the man who scored the first goal, the number 12, Ian Alisson. And Spurs have left the scene and gone up the tunnel. And on a night like this, it's no place for the losers. Circumstances. Tottenham 1, Arsenal 2. And there, the Arsenal manager George Graham wearing what he claims to be his lucky red scarf. Well, it wasn't luck tonight. It was sheer fortitude, resilience and great determination that took George Graham's Arsenal through to Wembley. What a picture.
What exhilarating scenes from White Hart Lane. What a magnificent cup tie it's been over three matches. And in fact, a tremendous evening, two great sporting events we've had so far. Charlie Nicholas could be out for 3 or 4 weeks with a bad